Que tal?
No, no me puedo decir.
Fine. So let me go for the next topic. So we have already seen the things like what are the interface and what is the abstract class. Now the next concept is called
Yes.
events. Events in the class. Okay, so now what I'll do? I'll go to SE24. SE24. See here, I'm going to create a class now. ZCL test 4, maybe. I don't know whether 4 is there or not. Okay, fine. So I'll create a description. I'll give a description here and remove this final and save it.
So one moment, sir.
Yep.
Sir.
Yep. Hello. Tell me,
Sir,
Joel.
like unable to view the screen very slowly, sir, after you do it. Hello,
Okay.
sir.
Okay. Got it.
Sir.
Yeah. Hello.
Sir,
Can you do?
unable to view the screen very slowly after you perform the things.
You
You
do
please
one.
record it, sir. I'll collect it later.
Okay, fine. So I'm recording it. Okay, fine. So let us assume.
Sir.
So here in this screen, I will give some methods.
Okay, sir.
Sometimes what will happen? There will be something called events. When you click a button, the event will trigger. Event is something like whenever you want to perform a dynamic action, events are required. So event definition is somebody asked you, what is the event? Events will perform a dynamic action. So, what kind of dynamic action means? Whenever you click a button, what action should it has to done? Whenever you give a user command, what kind of action it has to done? So that kind of things. Say for example, in this particular method, in this particular class, I will declare two methods. Methods M1. So maybe I'll declare instance public, and I'll also declare another method, method M2. Instance public. So I'm declaring two methods with instance public. Anyway, either way, if the thing is, you can also declare event handler method as a events as a static as well as instance. So both kind of instantiation is possible. You can either declare it as an instance or you can also declare it as a static. Now I'll go here to the events tab. And I'll declare one event here, event E1, give some name, I'm giving E1. So type, here you can give the type which kind of thing, which kind of event it is. So whether it is instance or static, I told both of them are possible. So give the instance and visibility, whether it is a public or protected or private. It is always better to give it as a public event. Always declare the event in a public section. You can also declare it in all the three sections. Now save it. Now come to the method. Now the flow will be like this. Method M1 will call event E1. Event E1 will in turn call method M2. Okay, so whenever you do some action, what will happen? Method M1 will trigger the event E1, and event E1 will trigger in turn triggers the method M2. So now I'll go to the method M1, and in the method M1 I'll write rise event E1. Rise event E1 is a keyword to rise the event, to trigger the event. So now
Yes, sir.
after this, what will happen? When the cursor sees this particular code of line, that event, particular event will be triggered. Now the next one, whenever event E1 is triggered, that event is dynamically calls the M2. So now you should create a relation between this event and M2. How to create a relation? Now click on this M2 and go here, click on the detail icon, detail view icon, click here. So there is something description if you want to give, yeah, you can give it. So we will call the method as event handler method. Because the method M2 is calling via event E1, we will call the method M2 as an event handler method. Okay, so give some description. Check here, event handler for. You give the, you need to give the class name here. What is the class? ZCL test 4. And what is the event?
E1.
So now if you give the event E1 and change, click on the change. So there is an icon here placed. So this is called event handler method. Okay, so if you put the handle, if you put your cursor here, you are getting a description event handler. So now I'll go here, I'll write some code inside this M2. Right. I was called by event E1. You give something, some code, some description here. I just want to show you how it will act at the time of calling the object. Now the thing is, the implementation is there, but we need to come back and then activate. Then it will say. Okay, so now our class got activated. Now go to AC38 to see the functionality of this. Here what you need to say, data obj type ref2. What is the class name? ZCL underscore test 4. Okay, then the next thing is startup selection, and how you will call the event. So rise event is already there in method M1. So I'll call the method M1 here. Call method obj. Oh, sorry, we are not created. We need to create that object first. So I need to write here create object obj. I'll say call method obj single arrow M1. Okay. So now save it, check it and activate. Now tell me, what is your expectation? After clicking, not clicking, see, for example, whenever the method is called, this method, the cursor will go inside this method M1. So whenever the cursor goes inside the method M1, it sees the rise event even keyword, then it need to call the method M2 in which we have written I was called via event E1. So that should come, but if I execute now, that will not come. See, if I am executing, but no output is coming up. What you need to do, you need to register the event here. That means you need to write some other code to register the event. Then only that event will be triggered. How to register the event? You write the keyword set handler. This is a keyword obj m2 for obj. I'll give this. I'll explain you what is this. Now see, I was called by event, E1 is coming. So what is this? Set handler, OBJM2, what is this? And for OBJ, what is this? This is, you are saying, this is a event handler method. M2 is a event handler method. So this event handler method is there in this particular object. This object has this class. In ZCL test 4, this event handler method is there. Okay? And for that, this is the object. And the event is there in this OBJ. So this is what set handler means. You need to register the event first like this. You need to say what is the event handler method. Then it will call, you say call method M1, then it will call the event handler. So this is how you can trigger the event. Now I will show you the same how to do it in local programming. Otherwise, before going to the local program, I'll show you one more example in the global only. So now what I have done, I have created method M1 and M2, and event also is there here in the same class. No, not required. Event will be triggered dynamically. You just call the event. Event will call a method. In that method, you can write the code. You can create n number of events. You can create any number of events.
And we need to relate them.
We need to relate for the particular method. Okay. So that relation will be there within the class or outside the class also you can relate. Say for example, I have two classes. So that's what I'm going to show now. So I'll create a class, give some description. So I'll create a method M1 here, instance public. I'll create event E1, instance public. I'll go to the method. I'll say here rise event E1, I'll tell you. So write event E1 and now save check activate, come back. I'll put the event handler method in some other class. That means I'll create another class. I'll declare here method M2. This I want as a event handler method. That means whenever that particular previous class, class 5, method M1 is called, that method will call the event. So event has to trigger this method. So what I will do, I will put here, that means method M2 is there. I'll go to the detail icon. I'll make it as a event handler method. I need to give the class name in which the event is there. So I'll give this as a 5. What is the event? E1. So this is the event handler method for the previous class event. Okay, like that you can make some method as a event handler method. So already there are in OOPS, like there are so many predefined classes are there. SAP has defined so many classes. If you want to use some method as an event handler method, you can use like this. So your event will be there in somewhere, event handler method will be there somewhere. Save it, check it, and activate. Come back. So now we have two classes. Now I will try to call this the same program, the previous program. I'll go. Here now, I'll give object 5. So in this is object, what I will say here, I'll say here object 1, type ref 2, ZCL 5. I'll declare one more object now, obj2, type ref2 zcl underscore test6. Now this object has a event handler method. This object has a event handler method, and this object has event plus the method which is calling the event. So now here I'll say create object obj1 comma obj2. Now which object you need to give here? Here you need to give where the method m2 is there. Where the method m2 is there?
Object
2. So you need to give here object 2.
For
object 1, you are calling the object 1. Here also you are calling the method from object 1. Now save it. Check it. Method m2 is unknown. Let us see in this class. Method m2 is instance private. Sorry, we need to declare it as a public. It went like a private, so that's why it's giving some error message over there. Welcome back. And here I will write some code so that it will appear in the output. So now I'll check here. Now it's syntactically correct. Now activate. Execute. Okay, so this is how you can trigger the event by event handler method. You can trigger, that means one method which is out of the class, which is not there in the class also, you can relate with the event. The same thing we will do with the local programming now. Now what I will do, I will create a class first, class C1 definition end class. So I have a public section, protected section, private section, there are three sections. Now in the public section, I will create method m1, I will create a method m1 and events e1 So now for this implementation is not there, I will do the implementation for method m1, class C1 implementation end class. Now I will write here method m1 end method. In between I will say rise event e1. Okay, so now I'll go to the next one, next class. I'll create one more class, class C2 definition end class. So this also has public section, protected section and private section.
Sir, you want to mention free.
Better to mention. If you don't mention, also not a problem, you just mention the public section, then it will be a public. So now I'll say here methods m2 for event e1 Event E1 is there in which class? Of C1. Now I'll say class C2 implementation . So here what I'll do, I'll call the event. So I need to implement the method M2 and method. Here what I want to do, here I'll just say give some write statement. I am event handler method. So this is done. Now after that, the remaining story is same. So data obj1 type ref to c1, obj2 type ref to c2, start of selection, create object obj1 comma obj2. Now then after this you need to set handler, correct, register the event. So set handler, set handler obj2 in which method M2 is there, for obj1 in which method M1 is there. So now call method obj1 single arrow. So this is your syntax to do it locally. So this is how the event handler method you can call by doing the programming in the same AC38 without the help of AC24. So with this we have finished almost all the things in Oops above. Now I'll tell you the practical example how to create a ALB report using this Oops above. Here in the program you want to you want to call the method and you want to get the data, correct? So
it's executing in the AC24,
correct?
In the program it's not
in the program means say for example here we have given a method, correct? So now I want to give one more method, interface F1. Okay, fine. In interface F1 only one method is there, okay? Now I'll declare one more method, method M2. So importing what method has to import is Weblen, okay? VBELN type, yeah, VBELN, okay? And okay, fine, that is that importing, only one importing is enough.
And exporting is work area.
Exporting is work area. Yeah, work area type.
VB.
Okay, fine, done. So method M2 is now there. So now if you have included this interface, so this class C1 has now method M2. Now I need to write the code to implement the M2. So what I'll do here, I'll say M2. Yeah, here you need to write the select query. So what I'll say, select okay single star from VBAK okay into work area where VBELN equal to VBELN. Okay, so now after this you will get the data into the work area. Fine. So now in the program what I'll do, I'll create a selection screen parameters p underscore VBELN type VBAK hyphen VBELN. Now after this I want to call the method m2, correct? So I want to call the method m2. After this, for the timing I will comment this. So now what I'll say, call method obj single arrow f1 tilde m2 okay exporting what you are exporting VBELN. So for VBELN you are exporting p underscore VBELN and importing what you are importing work area. Where you are importing that, you need to declare one variable in your program. So I'll declare one variable here, data some variable WF1 type VBAK. So I'll get this data into work area 1. After getting into this, I'll say write work area 1 hyphen VBELN and comma work area 1 hyphen VKORG, some other field in the same table. So I'll save it, check it, that way. P underscore weblon I need to give. Let me check, let me go for the table. VBAK I'll take some weblon. You give it here. Okay. So this is how you can get it.
By writing I am getting some problems.
Okay.
I have done the select query in importing exporting I have done, sir.
Okay.
Write I didn't get this.
Okay. Fine. So now this is okay. It's correct? Fine. Now let us go to some ALB OOPS report. Yeah, practical application of OOPS, like in general, now, till now you have learned the different concepts, how to implement the concepts. Now we are going to learn how to create an ALB report by using OOPS. So you may display the material data, you may display the sales order data, whatever may be the data. This is a practical implementation, how you are going to implement, how you are going to display the report. Okay, now yeah, other than report also you can use a report, like if you want to create a text editor. See, whenever you are going to the above editor, you are getting some screen which is like a white page. Correct. So if you want to get like that, there is a class. You can call the class, you will get that kind of screen. Okay, so just now, let's go to the title. So I'll give the ALB OOPS. So for ALV OOPS, SAP has created already so many classes are there in SAP, in above, already SAP defined classes are there. We will take and make use of those classes. Go to the SE24. There is a class called CL GUI Custom Container. Custom container, CLGUI custom container is there. So in our report we are going to make use of this, okay, and CLGUI grid display, and one more class is there. The class is CLGUI grid display. So this is another class, CLGUI grid. Let me check with the star. Oh, sorry, CLGUI, I think ALV grid. There is some other class. Yeah, CLGUI ALV grid. So this is another class. So now there are two classes I have shown you. Okay, so I'll tell you the steps here, what we are going to do now. So okay, so in my report, whenever you are developing the report, the first step is get the data into internal table. So first you declare internal table, maybe material data or sales data or whatever may be the data, you get it and put it into the internal table, which you are going to display as the output. So you do all the for all entries or inner join, whatever you want, you do all the operations, finally get the internal table data, final data. So now after that, so now to display the data, create a screen here. We need to create a screen. On the screen we are going to display this. Okay, so now what will happen at the runtime, your data will go and sit in the screen. Actually there won't be any screen, like if you are using reuse ALV grid display, on that what is happening, a screen is there, on the screen the data is going and sitting. But now here what will happen in ALV oops, so this is called online programming. Online programming means at the runtime the data will go and sit on that particular screen. You can use the same screen for some other data later. Okay, so now I'll go for here, create a screen. The third step, before displaying the screen, that means in process before output, so what you will do, create object for CLGUI custom container. So generally what we are doing in our classes, whenever we are doing the classes, we are creating the object for the class. Similarly, create object for the CLGUI custom container. For this CLGUI custom container, the input is custom container name, CUST name. I will tell you what is a custom container and what is a custom container name, I will show you when I am doing. Next, the fourth step is create, one moment, I am getting some call. So now what I will do, I need to create object for this CLGUI grid. So for this, if I want to create a CLGUI grid object, I need to give this object. I have created already object for custom container. So in order to create the object for CLGUI grid, you need to give that object as input. Object of what? Custom container. If you give this object of the custom container class to this class, then only this class will create an object. Then once you create the object, in this particular class CLGUI ALV grid, there is a method. The method name is set table for first display. So this is the method name. So you need to call this method set table for first display. This is just like your ReuGLV grid display. So in the ReuGLV grid display, you are able to give the field catalog, you are able to pass the internal table, you are able to give the events, all those are there in set table for first display. So you can use all those things. Okay. So set using the set table for first display is easy for you, but all these steps I will show you now. Just try to follow it. Now I'm in a report. So what I'll do, I will try to fetch data of the purchasing document. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll say data p underscore ebeln type ekko, otherwise ekpo hyphen ebeln. Okay, I want to get the data from ekpo table. So now I'll say start of selection. Here I'll say perform get data. I want to get the data into the internal table. So sorry, this I'll declare as a parameters, and I'll declare one internal table now. Data itab type table of ekpo. But in the real time, don't do like this. Don't give the entire structure. Declare a structure with the required fields and then only do the select query. Go to the perform get data. In the perform get data, I'm writing the logic here. So what I'm writing here is select star from ekpo into table itab, where what we can say ebeln okay is equal to p underscore, otherwise we can also give s underscore weblen. You can give that. Okay, maybe I'll give here only p underscore. Yeah, you can give select option also ebeln. So I'm getting the data into the internal table. So my first step is done. So now the second step, create a screen. Okay, so what I'll do here, call screen call screen 100 and double click on this. I'm going to a screen. Okay, so here screen, give some description. Go to the layout. Okay, so in the layout there is something called custom container, custom control. Okay, take the custom control and paste it on the screen. Give some name to it. I'll give the name CUST. Give some name. Remember the name. This is the custom control name. Okay, activate this. I'll tell you. On the particular area, in this area, at the runtime, the data will come and display. Okay, so the area name is CUST. Now this is called custom control. Custom control name is CUST. I'll go to the flow logic. I'll go to the PBO module status, double click, create the module in our program. If you want to give the PF status and all, you can give it. You know how to give the PF status. So now here the next step is create object for CLGUI custom container. What is the input for this? Custom control name. What is the custom control name we have given? CUST. Correct. So now what I'll do, I want to create object for that. So if I want to create object for that, so I will first declare the data here, data obj1 type ref2. What is the class name? CLUI custom container.
So standard class we need to use.
Yeah, standard class you are using. Okay. So now after that we are writing create object obj, but here we don't write the create object obj. What we'll do, we will go to the pattern, go here above object patterns, here something is called create object, select this. What is the object you are giving? Obj1. For which class? CLGUI custom container. Give that, press enter. So to create this object, container name is required. Container name is nothing but CUST. Give it. Okay, enable all exceptions and messages. So with this, what will happen? An object will be created for CLGUI custom container. So what is the input we have given for this? Custom control name we have given. So an object is created for this. So third step is over. Now let us go to the fourth step. What is the fourth step? Create object for CLGUI ALV grid. So now what I'll do? I'll declare here obj2 type ref2 CLGUI ALV grid. I'll come here, go to the pattern, go to the above objects pattern, select the second radio button, continue, and here you will give object 2, and here you will give the class name. Okay, so here there is something called I underscore parent. I underscore parent, what you will do, you will give obj1. Enable exceptions and messages. So in this step, what's happening? Your object obj2 has been created. Okay, so create object obj2 is done. Now we need to call a method, set table for first display, which is there in the CLGUI grid. That means which is there in the object obj2. So to call that, go to the pattern, go to the above objects patterns, go to the call method, instance is obj2 and class is, what is the class? CLGUI grid, put it here. And what is the method you are going to call? Set table for first display. Okay, set table for first display, continue. The set table for first display is having almost all the fields, say I underscore save, variant, structure name, field catalog, I underscore layout, everything as that of your ALV grid. Okay, so now what I'll do, I'll give I underscore structure name. What is my internal table? I tab has a structure of EKPO, so I'm giving EKPO here, and out tab you will give I tab. Enable exceptions and messages. Save it. Come back. Okay, I'm unable to mute this. Save it, check it, and activate. Let us see what is the error. Unable to interrupt I underscore structure name. Fine, I forgot to make the exporting. Now I'll activate. execute. Let me take some entry from ekpo. Okay, so say for example this one has 3 items. I'll give this in my report. Try to execute. What happened? Sorry, you need to activate everything. So oops, I'll be activate here, because sometimes what will happen, screen will not be getting active. So here in this case screen is not activated, so previously it not came, now it will come. Okay, so this is how you can display, you can scroll, you can see the data. Okay, so this is how you can practically get the ALV output by using methods, by using the OOPS concept.
This output is coming in that screen. What you are doing?
Correct.
Customer.
Yeah. And the thing is, if you want to put buttons, how you will put?
Set PF status.
And code you will write in?
PI.
Correct. Fine. So that part, I think maybe you can do it. Correct. So this is how you can make use of the whatever the things we have seen. Fine. So with this, we completed with OOPS ALV OOPS concept. So in the next class we'll go with the BAPI and then we'll go with the BADI. So there are 2 more concepts, BAPI and BADI. Then we'll go with the workflow. So BAPI will take 2 days, BADI will take 2 days. Maybe workflow will start in the next Saturday, Sunday. We'll try to complete on next Saturday and Sunday. Maybe next Monday or next Wednesday, that means upcoming, we can finish off with the course. Okay, so today is already, what is the date? 19th. So today is 19th, 26th, or yeah, before this 29th or something, after 26th, just after 1 or 2 days, we can finish off. Okay, so maybe 28th or 29th, we can finish, I think. Fine. So, okay, so tomorrow I will, don't come, you just practice these things. So, you just practice with whatever we have learned, and Monday we'll start with BAPI. Okay? Fine, so I'm going out of the meeting. Okay, so Adich and Javed, are you there still? Okay then. Okay, fine. Yep. Bye.